and welcome to Beer Goggle. I'm sorry. Hello and welcome to Beer Goggle's Reviews. We're going to North. We're going to Yorkshire. I know. It's not good. I'm sorry. I shouldn't really kind of try accents and silliness. And look, it's all fun. We're going across the borders and things. We're going up to North, to Yorkshire. We're going to Theakston. Or is it Theakston? Is the name of the brewery Theakston? It's Theakston. Is that what it is? It's Theakston. We're going Theakston and we're going to have Masham Glory. 4.7% ABV from Masham in North Yorkshire. Stop it, Terry. This is a beer specially brewed to celebrate the glorious tradition of brewing in Masham. Theakstons have been brewing their ales continuously in the Yorkshire Dales market town for over 185 years, using family recipes passed down from one generation to another. Cool, brilliant. Now, I think Theakstons are the ones that do Old Peculiar. Unless I'm very much mistaken, I think they are. And it was, Theakstons was, what is it, Jamie Theakston? No, what was it? Came down, what was it? No, that was Black Sheep. Came down and started Black Sheep off, and right? And he was one of the brewing, family brewers there. But it kind of handed around a little bit, and now it's back in the family. So, being looked after again by the family, by the Theakstons. This is 4.7% premium ale, 4.7% ABV, and it is Masham Glory. Masham up, let's go. Crack it and taste it. Let's see what we've got in here. Nothing's exploded. That is a very, very dull and boring looking crown. But it's not what's on the top of the bottle, it's what's inside. I do like the pretty crowns though, but there you go. They can't all be pretty. Like me. It's what's inside that's important. As the actor said to the bishop. Right, stop it. Right, pour a little bit in my glass. Nice little head there. Not really gripping on much, and it's dissipating fairly quickly. There's not a lot of carbonation going on, but it's very blip, very gently going, no, gently done. Yeah, that's well, I like that. I don't really like a gassy drink. Too many beers in this day and age are gassy because every advert you see has got an 8-inch head on the top of it. Leave the gases out of it. Come on, we don't need them. It's nice to have a little bit of sparkle on the tongue, but too much, and you know, you're kind of defeating the object. You're not even tasting the beer. Right, the colour you're getting is the top of this flame on the glass. On the thing, the card in the end. The top there is the colour you're getting through. I'm getting through the glass. Clever stuff, isn't it? Right, let's have a sniff. Ooh, smells nice. That smells lovely. So a bit of air up my nose. Right, let's see if I can pick these out for you. Garibaldi biscuit. A little bit of a little bit of whipped cream, a kind of squirty whipped cream as well. Just swirl that on the table because I've got a bit much in there to get a proper swirl with my hand. You're getting a hint of grape in there. Kind of like a Riesling. Oranges, you're getting blood orange. And something red or around the sort of, I don't know if it's a cherry or a, you're getting a bit of gooseberry, but there's some, I don't think it's a cherry or cool, what is it? It's like a raspberry. A little bit of raspberry in there. Right, let's dive in. Cheers. Oh, that's lovely. Yeah, I like that. I like that. It's kind of, it waters out a little bit quick towards the finish. But the finish does still hang on. But the mouthfeel seems to be woof, big and thick. And you know, if you've got a big load there, big chewy amount in your mouth, and it suddenly goes, but leaves the mouthfeel kind of dry behind on your tongue. And you've got kind of a sweet kind of dryness on the tongue, a kind of sweet coffee dryness. Almost like a kind of a, if you get these pre-made powders and you have a little bit you've got on your finger or something, and you just put it on your tongue. These pre-made like kind of latte powders and things that you get in the little sachets, and you tear it off and pour it in, you go, oh, I've got a bit on my finger, like that. It's kind of like that, a bit of sweetness on your kind of straight on the tongue, but it's kind of dry at the same time. That's lovely. That really is nice. It's a lovely drinking, proper drinking beer that's just like, sit down, let's get into this. You know, it's kind of not overly challenging. It's not kind of, it's not trying to blow your mind in any way. But at the same time, it's just sitting there, you know, it's one of them you just sit with your mates, have a nice drink, and really enjoy the drink and the company. Sometimes you kind of, the company's getting in the way of you enjoying the drink, and the drink's getting in the way of you enjoying the company, sort of thing. And you know, sometimes you get a drink that's so complex and that you're going, oh, hold on, I'm torn between lovers here, you know, that sort of thing. Whereas that is just one of those, you could be doing something else, playing a game of cards with your mates, or you know, anything. They're just having some sort of food, having a bit of a meal, and you're cutting away and having a bit of that, you're enjoying everything. That is just a lovely, lovely beer. Really lovely. Go for that. As a kind of one of these, drink any day you like ones. Enjoy that one. Theakston's Masham Glory. Bite, try it, like it. Cheers. Bottoms up. Cheers.